In the late 19th and early 20th centuries, Japan went through a period of rapid expansion. It invaded foreign lands in China, the Dutch East Indies, the Philippines, and Malaya, and developed itself to be the superpower of the Far East. But over the next three decades, its prosperity waned with poor economic policy. Meanwhile, Japan also poured much money into the development of a state-of-the-art military. And then, at the close of the 1930s, war was declared, and Japan, still facing the situation of severe economic trouble, sided with Germany, hoping that her military might would come out victorious. As a result of this, the Japanese hoped that they could gain ownership of the many German-controlled colonies in the Pacific. The Japanese also pushed for territorial expansion during the war. Their skilled armed forces quickly overtook large parts of China and all of Singapore, whilst also attacking the American forces at Pearl Harbor, where they endeavored to knock America out of the war before they had even entered it. The next major frontier was Australia, and to base themselves for an attack on the Australian mainland, they first had to conquer Papua New Guinea, or PNG, and so they did. While Japanese naval forces attempted to take Port Moresby by sea, their land-based forces began to cross Papua New Guinea via the Kokoda Track. Whilst the advance was tough, the Japanese forces encountered little opposition. Slowly, resistance by Australia's largely untrained Citizens Military Force, or CMF, increased, putting more pressure on the Japanese forces. Also, as Japanese forces pushed further inland, their supply lines were stretched, meaning that their front line could not be as well supported with food, weapons, or first aid. The number of Australian military personnel defending then increased in mid-1942, with the arrival of the 7th Division of the Australian Imperial Force. There would eventually be nearly 85,000 Allied troops fighting for control of the Kokoda Track, among them 54,000 Australians. The battle for the Kokoda Track was fought in hot, humid, tropical weather, with almost constant rain and storms. It was not uncommon for 25 centimetres of rain to fall on any single day. These weather conditions not only had a huge effect on the morale and comfort levels of troops, but also helped to make the track no more than a muddy sludge into which battle-weary soldiers could sink up to their calves with each step. It was a track surrounded on every side by an unwelcoming and unforgiving jungle. The track was not flat. It rose to heights of up to 7,000 feet or 2,200 meters. The brave men who fought here suffered not only from the constant threat of the Japanese, but also from natural enemies like outbreaks of malaria and dysentery. When the Japanese advance was reversed and the Australians had forced the opposition back down to the northern beaches, it was clear that Australia's final line of defence had held and that she was finally saved from the risk of invasion. This was the first military defeat of Japan in the Pacific theatre of World War II, and so marked the beginning of their downfall. The men that fought so dearly and endured such horrendous conditions are, in modern times, credited with saving Australia from invasion. Their heroism is widely celebrated and admired, and their story lives on, lest we forget.